Hi folks, so today's video is about a Harbor Freight TV mount. Yeah, this is the one they sell for $18, and I've been watching it for a while, and so I was ordering some gloves, and I went ahead and ordered this TV mount for $17 with shipping. This is how it was packed. They actually shipped it to me like this, and you know, FedEx didn't do too much to it to destroy it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open it up, and I'm going to mount it on the wall back here. I have an extra TV that's got some crap on it, but it's still a 32-inch TV, so I'm going to put it here so sometimes when I am working at my computer, I can have the TV on in the background if I want to watch the news or kind of monitor a show. So anyway, with that said, let's get started and see where this leads. Fits most TVs between 37 and 70 inches, so it's probably bigger than the TV I should have ordered it for. Yeah, you know what? It just is what it is. So we will separate out the packaging and the instructions. Now, they're showing it using, and I have to say, this is actually pretty nicely packaged. So you've got your anchors here, and then some washers, and some lag bolts, and some screws, and washers. It's actually kind of nice that it's separated out. Some of the higher quality ones that I've done are like that, and then you've got some lock nuts or lock screws that are installed here, and hopefully my head camera will show these. You know, I guess that's the tilt mechanism there. You know, it's not bad overall. It is a cheap mount. I probably wouldn't have any problem using it in like a secondary bedroom. I don't think it's what I want to put in my master bedroom though. Mainly because I want something with pivot in the master bedroom. This doesn't look too bad. So now that we've read the instructions, we'll get the TV and take a look at it. It's always a good idea to see the TV fit before you start to install the mount. So what I want to see is just how much larger. Oh, it's a couple inches. It'll be okay because I'll probably upgrade this TV at some point to something bigger. Because that TV is going to wind up in my garage. And let's just see what it looks like in this spot. Yeah, that's workable. So, it's always best to do these in reverse. So next, I need a towel. So it's always important to protect the TV from the surface you're laying it on, even though this is a wood TV tray in this case. I'm going to lay just a hand towel over this. And as I said, this TV, this was my first flat screen TV, and it's destined to go in my garage at some point, but I'm not ready for that yet. So it's just a great extra TV to have. So what I want to do is I want to figure out how this is going to mount to here, and it looks like it's going to mount just like that. And these go at the top because the hooks go down. So that looks pretty good there. And then I want to see which of these screws fit, and I'm just going to start with these. Bullseye. And I want to go get some Loctite. So I've got some Loctite and I've got a drill. And the reason for these two things, the Loctite's gonna keep the screws in the back of the TV. And this is gonna save my hands. So I did a test fit. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put my hardware together. Now, if I was not using Loctite, it would be important to use the star washers or some other lock washer. But because I'm using Loctite, I just need to put a little bit of thread locker on here. Thread locker is actually the right name for this. And these screws are too long. That was what I was kind of afraid of when I looked at them. And I don't see any short screws. So these screws are too long. However, I've been down this road just one too many times. And so I have an entire selection of screws here. And I think these look like 8/32, 1/2 inch. Let's just see. If I'm right, something tells me it's metric. Yeah, they're metric. Don't think that I have any reasonably decent metric. Although, nope. Well, it does turn out that I have a full assortment of M4 hardware. And this is actually looking like it might be M4, which would be really ironic because I ordered a bunch of this for another project. Yeah, I think these are actually M4. So let's see. And I really have a preference for cap washers. No, it is not M4. And I just had M5 out. Oh no, that's M3. Which means M4 is in here. I have M3 and M4, which are two very common sizes. M4 10. Let's see if I have anything longer than a 10. Because 10's kind of a common. M420, that's too long. I really need like some M415s. M412, that probably work. Bullseye. So these are M4 screws. And then if we're feeling really lucky, no, I ain't gonna get that easy. So I need to go find a hex key for this. I'll be right back. All right, so I'm really lucky that I have M4 screws because this is not something that I normally would have expected to have. I would have said, nope, sorry, don't stock those. But it turns out that I do. You do not want to force screws that are too long into your TV because it will damage it. Most of the TVs should be protected against that, but you really do want to watch the length of the screws. And that's the only critical thing I have so far on this. Thank you. Yeah, so this TV was made in September of 2007. So it is, it's been around the block for a while. I don't really remember where I bought the TV. I'm gonna throw the screws that I can't use in the recycle bin, which just happens to be sitting at my feet. Alright, so last screw here. Now, there is an opportunity here to, there's a little bit of wiggle in the way these mounts work, so I want to just take a second and make sure my mounts are squared up, because it will drive me nuts if this TV is not level. I'm going to pull it all the way down, and then I'm just going to line it up as best I can by eyeball and tighten back up. And I think that's going to be good, because that should raise the TV up a little bit. And this mount allows for a little bit of adjustment, which actually turns out to be good, because this needs to be viewed at a little bit of an angle. Alright, so, done with my Allen key, and I'm done with my Loctite. And then I'm just going to eyeball this and kind of tilt this out. And then just lock it down. That's nice. They're reverse threaded bolts, so that means they both spin in the same direction. So that's mounted, and next thing we want to do, believe it or not, is take care of the power cord. So it will be far easier to do this right now than it will be later. And so what I want to do is I want to take the power cord, and then I want to zip tie it in place. The reason to zip tie it is it can never get pulled down accidentally. Gets caught and it gets pulled out of the TV. It's just a pain in the butt to work on these when you're upside down. So while you have all this together, go ahead and mount this. The other thing that's worth mounting is an HDMI cable, but that's not as difficult. There's that stray screw. And because I like to do quality work on my installs, go ahead and clip that and it can go in the recycle bin. Now, if you're mounting this outdoor, it's really important to install a drip loop. A drip loop is where the wire comes down and then back up before it enters in. And you can, so let's say that my finger is the entry point. That would be a drip loop that allows water to run down and drip out. You can form them. You'll see on cable installations, they'll frequently do this somewhere along the outside of the house where there's just a little loop in there, and that loop serves as a drip, as drip protection to keep water from running down the line and into your residence or structure. Okay, so I'm pretty excited about this. This looks good. Next, I need to mount the piece on the wall. So let me take this off. And just lean it up against the wall for a minute. I think that's good. So the next thing I need to do is figure out where the studs are. What I want to do is, I know there's a stud here, and I absolutely know for a fact there's a stud there on the edge of the wall. And this house is 16 inches on center. And I have a network box below that one and an outlet below that one. So I pretty much can be, okay, yeah, I'm on target. Yep, it's on the left side of that box and it's on the left side of that box. Hey, I'm consistent. I put my boxes on the right side in both cases. So now what I need to do is go get a drill bit. I need to pre-drill my hole. Not 100% sure what these black washers are for. Let's see if the instructions tell us anything interesting. Oh, those are spacers. Yeah, they wouldn't have done anything anyway. So those are supposed to go between the mounts and the back of the TV in order to create some additional space, but I just telling you that this would not do anything. And Harbor Freight knows this is a problem because they say don't insert your screws too far. Thanks, guys. You know, an eighth of an inch wouldn't have cured the fact that the screws were a quarter inch too short. So let me go find a drill that matches with, I don't know if I want to use these or not. I think these are junk. I'm gonna throw them away. And that concludes my use of Harbor Freight hardware. I prefer something that I never have to fight with again, so I'll be right back. I decided to go with what I think is superior hardware. I'm gonna use some SPAC screws and some number 6 fender washers that came from Bolt Depot. These are quality fasteners. Number 8 would actually be better. Let me see if I have a number 8 fender washer. I do. This is a really, really good illustration of why I started stocking a lot of hardware. I wanted something that I could count on. I needed quality hardware, and Home Depot and Lowe's and the like just don't carry quality hardware. So I got ticked off one day and I bought a lot. Everything in number 6, number 8, number 10, and quarter inch that I'm likely to need for every project that I'm likely to engage in. Now, I still sometimes have to buy stuff, but it's not very often. And this is a absolutely perfect example of why I did that. So I need a level. That one's too small. So I just want something that's easier to handle because I'm fixing to climb up here on my desk and mess with this. All right, so. I think that's right. Yeah, I want this nice and high. Miss. All right, three misses. It's time to hunt for it the hard way. And I do have confidence that it's in this vicinity. There it is. So I was a half inch off or so. This does not appear to have a top or bottom, so what I need to do now is just reestablish where I want this. Push that in. Now, I've intentionally tilted that out of my way. I'm actually going to tilt it back up. And what I want to do now is level this. All right. That's good enough. Now, it's important to watch out for wires when you're doing this. Now, I happen to know my wires are not in up here in the wall. But if you didn't, you would want to watch out for that. So now I'll secure both of these. SPAC screws are expensive, but they're very strong and they're very good. And they do not strip out. So it's easy to remove them in the future when you need to. Okay, so that's that. Oh, but first, I need to put the instructions in the right spot. Recycling. There we go. Not bad. This can be repositioned a little bit. It would be a lot easier if I had the desk out of the way, but that's good enough. And I think that when I'm sitting down here, I'll be able to look up. I actually want to tilt it some more. So I'm going to see about adjusting it. Oops. So I'm going to give it full adjustment here. Because I think that tilting it the maximum amount will make it easier to view. Go. This does take a little bit of upper body strength. I will admit that. So, you know, that's not perfect, but it's certainly good enough. There are some limitations that are very obvious to this. One of which is you could slide the TV completely off. Now, it has locks in the bottom, but they look like they're a real pain in the butt to adjust and to get to, so I'm not gonna mess with them. Yeah, they actually need to be adjusted. So, famous last words. I wasn't gonna adjust them, but now I'm going to. So, there are screws in the bottom here, and the problem is they stick out and interfere with its engagement on the rail. I'm still not going to lock them down, but if you were installing this in a commercial environment or for a child, I would strongly recommend that you lock those down. For my situation in a house on the first floor in Houston, Texas, in an office where only adults go, in a house with only adults, it does not need to be engaged. So, next step, it's Tivo time. So I've got my Tivo Mini here. I have a bunch of Tivo Minis, and that's what I'm gonna hook up to this TV. So first things first, we need to untangle the cable. Arr, boy, that's actually kind of at the limit of my capacity, but there's no way that I would have been able to do this with it against the wall. I think it'll stay here for 2 seconds. There we go, I got lucky. That was a bad thing to do, but I got lucky. All right, see if I can get lucky again. So we're in place. Now, one of my challenges is what to do with the actual Tivo unit itself. So I'm gonna have to throw the cable behind here and the power supply back here. And I think Tivo and Alexa are gonna become friends. There we go. then let's see how mad Tivo is at me for having been off for months. Okay, so Tivo's not incredibly mad at me. I was afraid Tivo would be angry at me for having been off for a month and a half. Almost there. Get a ball of yarn, knit something special, because Tivo takes a while. Tivo's definition of almost there is like go eat lunch and come back. Tivo delivers a world-class entertainment experience. I will give it that. It is a fantastic device for watching TV. However, it is a premium price with the cheapest hardware they can find, which generally delivers an adequate performance when it's new, and it only gets worse over time. They're addicted to selling hardware, which is one of the reasons the company has struggled. Just a few minutes more, and they really mean a few minutes, as an emphasis on several. There we go, finally. So, networking does not appear to be connected. Let me go fix that problem. So one of the things that I found is that Tivo does not play nice with gigabit Ethernet equipment mixed in with the rest of my network. So what I've done is I have isolated Tivo to a dedicated gigabit switch because a lot of the equipment is 100 megabits, and that way it can all be slow and happy together and not interfere with the rest of my network. So, there you have it. I've got, I was able to get my TV working and I put it on CNN. I hope they won't mind me showing them for 5 seconds in my video. I'm really happy to have my TV in my office and connected to my TiVo. Thanks for watching my video. I hope you found this interesting and entertaining. Please feel free to like, comment nice things, and share with others. Have a great night.